senior teachers are continuing with their classes, and day after tomorrow, that is Monday onwards, even we are planning to extend this, our remote classes, so-called remote classes, even for lower classes. This is what we have planned. And if you remember, there was few days back in WhatsApp group, I had posted a book, I believe on Thursday, 2-3 days back. Yes. NCERT has published one book which is exclusively for these situations and for primary classes. That is one very big initiative what NCERT and CBSE has taken. So, I will be discussing about those things also here. Now, this introduction, of course, you can go through. Many countries, including India, have been facing the challenges created due to outbreak of coronavirus, which is now called as COVID-19. Of course, that is, you can go through. I shall rush to the important points, like since this is a different experience for all of us, we have a challenge to deal with this situation. That is what the phase in which we are going on. In this uncertain situation, children sitting at home, away from their friends and teachers, may also feel anxiety and stress. For this reason, I suggest whenever you talk to any of the parent or any of the child, be polite, be little more sober, and try to absorb the negativities whatever are there, okay, and don't bounce them back. That is it. Now, the effect of all this on mental health of individuals across all age groups, particularly our children, is of a serious concern. All these are the statements which I have copied from the book which has come from the NCERT a few days back. Alright? And let me go to the main part of it. First, strategies to reduce stress and anxiety for teachers. A certain level of stress is normal. We keep on having that during our normal course of time also. Finishing the assignments at stipulated time. That is what I mean. But when exposed to repeated stressful events without the tools to manage feelings, stress can become emotionally and physically toxic. That is it. We need to avoid this sort of situations. Now, yes. Teachers may follow the following activities to reduce their stress and anxiety. Keep engaged but not get overloaded with work. First point, which maybe I think we may have to contradict with this because we are not very much got used to this sort of classes, like remote classes or online classes or teaching through the technologies. This is we are not very much into. Work together like a team with family members to avoid piling on too much work on the same day. Keep moving around the house, shifting from one type of work to other, taking stretching breaks. Listen to music, keep singing, keep playing instruments, etc. Have a routine of sleep, work, time with family, and time with self. These are few tips. Now, a teacher should keep 8 hours of sleep. It helps to maintain both physical and emotional health. Prepare a daily schedule and follow it. Get up early, work out, sleep early, and get up early. That would be better, right? Work out, it helps to get out of stress and anxiety, give energy, and also it gives energy working out, and also helps to sleep better. Fortunately, we are in a gated community where teachers, I'm talking about the teachers who are residing inside the campus, you will have a chance to come out and walk around and in the evenings or in the morning and even in the afternoon also. So you come out, relax, move around, and you can work out. Spend quality time with family, laugh loudly and freely, have hygiene food during meal time, try to consume lot of fruits, vegetables, mixed grains, proteins, etc. Eat together, play simple games. These are few of the things. Now coming to the work portion of ours. For the situations what we are having, it is suggested to have offline classes. For the situations whatever we are in, because online classes were taken by Mr. Arjun Rajan Saikia, that is biology department, and of course they are still going on, but that would be okay only for those people who are well equipped with those things. Since there is a broadband connection, they are able to do it in their residence and they are able to check on the number of students who are attending. That is good. But it would not be possible for everyone. Okay, so it is suggested to have offline classes. For all of us, it is suggested to have offline classes. That means videography or audiography. Do this one. Do videograph or audiograph your classes. Videograph or audiograph your classes. Keep them in soft copy form. Send it to the children when your turn comes. Your turn comes means when we have given a schedule also. On particular schedule we are supposed to give the upload the material. So whenever your schedule comes, that time you can very well upload. So if it is videography, as suggested earlier, prepare PowerPoint presentation and bring it to the smart board. This is the board. In my last lecture, I was explaining how to use this and bring it to the smart board, fix it in the school in different rooms, play it on the screen, explain it to the students. During this process, record it. Whatever I am doing it, same thing I request all of you to do. Same thing here also, I have prepared the PPT and rather Mr. Mushidil has prepared this PPT and I am explaining this and recording and sending it to the concerned people. In my case it is teachers and in your case it would be students. During this process, fix your mobile at certain distance exactly in front of the board. Please ensure this, the mobile in which you are recording, that should be at a fixed distance, not moving. Please don't take it from one corner, from any corner, so that you get a diagonal view of the board and the teacher. That is not suggested. Direct, if you take, that would be better. And during this process, fix your mobile at certain distance exactly in front of the board, focusing only on smart board. If you change the focus to your face or to your explanation, whatever is written on the board will not be seen clearly. That is why the focus need to be on the board itself. That is it. And then next. Or if you are comfortable with the green board, that means the normal green boards what we are having, this sort of green boards, if you want to use that, in many of the classrooms they are there, so you can use that. But here also, while you are recording it, please fix the mobile at certain distance. Now moving to the next slide. Yes. This standard is given already. This has been circulated to you and even to the parents also. I believe it has reached parents as well. This is for class 12. The previous one is from classes 6 to 10. timetable, uploading time is given as 11 a.m. All concerned teachers need to make their presentations ready a day before. That means tomorrow is Sunday. Day after tomorrow's timetable, whatever is there, all those classes are to be uploaded by 11 a.m. on Monday. That means tomorrow by evening itself, the preparation portion must get over. And tomorrow night must be utilized for uploading the data. Now, what is this uploading? This uploading into either YouTube or into any of the drive, Google Drive or whatever it is. So when you do that, what happens on that particular day? That means on Monday, you would be able to give the link directly to the students. That should happen before 11 a.m. That is it. So, for uploading bigger files, it takes lot of time. So, we may keep it for uploading in the night. That means, day after tomorrow, if you want to deliver a lesson, your lesson must be kept for uploading tomorrow night itself. Now coming to the next point. The Google Classroom is prescribed method of reaching students. Google Classroom is prescribed method of reaching students. Since it is simple to handle, and records like assignments, worksheets, and work done by the students can be maintained. Alright? So, how to create this Google Classroom? That also we will discuss separately. Maybe group wise I will be able to discuss. Group wise means department wise. Or individually, as I was discussing about the implementation of board with the different groups of teachers. Alright? So, Google Classroom, everyone. For this Google Classroom, you need to have Google account or Gmail account you are expected to have. If you have it, you can open a Google Classroom. Now, video recording need to be done in your own mobile. Preferred time duration is between 10 minutes to 30 minutes. Please don't go beyond 30 minutes and below 10 minutes. If your topic is very short and you can explain that before 10 minutes, that is okay. But the preferred time is 10 to 30 minutes. Because below 10 minutes, if you are recording something, that might not serve as one class, one full length class. That is why I prefer you to have between 10 minutes to 30 minutes. Record your lecture in high resolution. While you are recording it in the mobile, that should be in the high resolution. So when you do this, what happens when you compress it or when you transfer it, even that time the quality of the video will be maintained. Keep your mobile always light. By transferring recorded videos, WhatsApp messages and other files to your OTG pen drive. The pen drive, whatever you are having, into that you transfer all these videos, whatever recorded videos or WhatsApp messages. And nowadays, since you are there at home, you will be getting lot many mobile messages and all. So all those things, you keep them away so that you will have enough space in the pen drive. So, now moving to the next slide. Yes. It's not okay. Before videography, using smart board, what are the things to be made ready? Make your PPT ready. Write all possible notes or pictures or videos, audio clippings in a form of PPT. While scanning or taking photo in mobile, see the clarity of the picture. That has to be visible. Clarity should be maintained. And after videography, what is to be done after videography? Compress the video in any compressing software installed in your mobile. Compress. Usually, let us say 30 minutes video. 30 minutes video usually is coming around 3 GB. And if it is 10 minutes, depending on the quality of the mobile, this would be 10 minutes of video, this is coming to 1.2 GB or 0.8 GB, in this range it is coming, 10 minutes video. And 1.2 GB for uploading is quite difficult into the website or anywhere, either to YouTube or to WhatsApp message or to Google Drive, it would be quite difficult. Now what we need to do is, we need to compress this one. The 3 GB can be very well compressed into, the 3 GB can be very well compressed into 500 MB. It would be possible. 1.2 GB can be easily compressed to maybe, and all these values are arbitrary values. Whatever experimentations I have done till now in last 5-6 days, based on that I am giving. 1.2 GB can be brought down to at most 200 MB. When this is done, it becomes easy for you to upload into the YouTube. Alright, so that is it. Compressing is very much important. And for that compressing, you need to have either AVC free, you need to install this app in your mobile, or InShot, or AVC free. AVC free refers to any video converter, free version. Actually, there is a paid version also for this, no need of getting that. The free version would do, that is any video converter. This is one good one, and another one is InShot. This is also free version. You can very well download through Google Play Store. So this is it. Till now, where we have come? We have come till recording, that your class has been recorded and that is being compressed into a smaller file. Oh God. Not thank you, love itself.